Are you curious how the Milton real estate market's doing these last few months of 2020? If so, you're gonna wanna watch this video. Welcome to the Milton Market Minute. I'm Shaleni Enriquez with RE/MAX Real Estate Center, and your time is valuable. So over the next minute or so, I'm gonna break down what's really happening in the Milton real estate market, helping you make sense of it all. The September stats are in, and the best way to describe what happened in Milton in September is...
That's hot.
That's right, thanks Paris. With our average home price hitting over $910,000, that's a 22% increase over sales from September 2019. Our average year-to-date sales price is up 12.95%. Also up are home sales. In September, across all home types, we had 285 sales in Milton, and that's a 66% increase over what we had in September 2019. Year-to-date, and despite the shutdown that we had for COVID, overall now we're seeing that sales have caught up, and we're up about 1.5% year-to-date over sales from 2019. We're sitting at 1,825 home sales year-to-date versus the 1798 home sales that were reported as of September 2019. Biggest question I've been getting lately, what is causing these prices? Well, it's a couple of things. One is because more people are able to work from home. Because more people are able to work from home, we've actually seen an increase in the 416 folks that are living in condos in Toronto, leaving those behind and coming out to the suburbs. They're looking for more space, they're looking for detached homes. If that's you and you fall into the category of someone considering leaving Toronto, I'm gonna make sure I put a link to a video that I just made that goes over the pros of choosing Milton as your next home. Another reason for these substantial price increases are interest rates. Interest rates are very, very low right now. Actually, one of the mortgage brokers that I work with was recently able to get a client 1.6% on their 5-year fix, which is one of the lowest rates that I've ever seen. So it's very inexpensive to get into a mortgage right now. Another factor is inventory is low. So inventory in Milton is down still 9.1% off of 2019. So when you have a market where inventory is low, but you have a lot of buyers that want to buy, that puts us into a very, very strong seller's market. And that's why you're seeing these bidding wars and offer dates on a lot of the homes. One of the indicators that I always look for to see the liquidity of the market is a statistic called the absorption rate. The absorption rate can help us determine if a market is balanced market, a seller's market, or a buyer's market. Essentially, what the stat does is that it shows us if no other homes were to come onto the market, how long would it take us to sell the inventory that we have in place, or for the market to absorb the current supply. So just to illustrate how strong a seller's market we have in Milton, I'm going to calculate the absorption rate for detached homes from September 2020. So to calculate it, you take the number of active listings for 1 month, so we're gonna look at September, and then you also take the number of sold listings for that same month. You divide the number of active listings by the number of sales to determine the months of inventory remaining. So for detached homes in Milton, it's not even 1 month, it was 0.68. So as a general rule, 5 to 6 months of inventory is considered to be a balanced market. Anything more than that would be considered a buyer's market, and anything less is a seller's market. So with not even 1 month of inventory, if all the homes that were active were to sell for detached properties, you wouldn't even be able to get through the whole month before we would run out of supply. So you can see the combination of the low interest rates, heightened demand for suburban properties like Milton, especially in the detached home market, and tight inventory conditions are creating this strong seller's market. If you are thinking of buying or selling in this market, I'm going to leave links below to both my buyers and seller guides. They are full of essential tips to help make sure that you win in real estate. If you have questions about what's happening in your neighborhood, I would love to chat with you. Give me a call and I'd be happy to answer any questions that you have. Next week, we're going to answer any questions that you have about staging your home for sale. And I'm gonna have a special guest. So if you haven't subscribed to our channel already, make sure you do so, so you don't miss out on any of our great content all about Milton and Milton real estate. Also, if you're looking for some fun activities, activities to do this fall, I'm gonna make sure I put a link to my video about the best places to see the fall leaves here in Milton. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next week.